The Philippine Central Bank moved to free up more funds for loans on Friday by changing the definition of deposit substitutes, which are subject to reserve requirements. BDO President and the Management Association of the Philippines Management Man of the Year, Nestor Tan, is excited about the move.
I'm quite positive with that move because I think the economy needs the liquidity now to support the growth.
Security Bank Chief Economist Dan Roses is also excited, but he notes it will likely take some time before the new rules have an impact, adding the total reduction of 75 basis points in key interest rates and the 400 basis point reduction in banks' reserve requirement ratios have yet to have an effect, although the last 100 basis point cut in RRR will only happen in December.
We're only seeing some growth in terms of liquidity, but loan growth or banking activity has not been really moving yet. It's flat.
Tan, however, says lending should be turning the corner right now.
Because of the budget delays, there's just been a little bit of slowdown in loan activity, but I do believe it will pick up towards the latter part of this year, right about this time, and then going into next year.
Infrastructure spending will require more bank lending, and government is now leaning more than ever on the private sector with the introduction of 29 public-private partnerships in the revised infrastructure flagship project list. The NAIA International Airport facelift by the so-called Super Consortium is one of those projects. Megaworld is part of the consortium, and it has its own infrastructure projects as well.
The NAIA project is nearing its final stages before we go into Swiss Challenge, and I think the SkyTrain project is now scheduled for ICC board.
But Tan says the ramp up in borrowing and spending should still be done carefully.
The more people participating in it, the better for us, as long as we don't choke with so many projects simultaneously.
The Philippine Central Bank will release its latest data on money supply for the month of October on November 29, Friday. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.